13th of October 2020. No worries, it's not Friday, it's just Tuesday. Piotr, here's the slide for his global YouTube channel. A new week, new opportunities. Let's start with the risk warning. Guys, please bear in mind, trading on margin carries a high level of risk, may not be suitable for all investors. You can sustain a loss of some or initial investment, so please do not invest the money you cannot afford to lose. Seek education, gain experience before risking real money. However, past performance doesn't guarantee future results. Okay, so what we have yesterday in US, Columbus Day, bank holiday in Canada as well. There was some trading going on, but of course the volume was not that good. Anyway, Tuesday, we had the German final CPI, minus 0.2 versus minus 0.2 expectations. And we got the UK job market, Claimant Count Change 28.1, expectations 78.8. And we got the unemployment rate 4.5 versus 4.3 expectations. Average earnings index at zero, better than minus 0.6 expectations. So that was the morning data. So it was related to Euro, it was related to the UK. So first chart we are going to go through is Euro pound. The thing is that the bears, first thing first, bears were able yesterday, after the start of the new week, close the day below the weekly open. So yesterday, again, we tested latest weakness we have here on the Euro pound, right? We are trying to bounce, but of course, for now, in my opinion, if you are a conservative, you are waiting for the clearing one of the levels. Either we are going to break through 90-20 and psychological 90, or we are going to get back above 90-62, the weekly open. And with that being said, and conservative approach, this type of the setup could be in place from your perspective. If you are more aggressive, then probably you are trying to trade the latest weakness. You are trying to trade over under, right, when it comes to the Euro pound intraday chart, and you are currently long. Well, we will see how it's going to play out, me personally, but please do your own research and do remember about the risk disclaimer. I'm slightly to the upside. I'm bearish pound for a quite long time. And with Euro pound, I do expect move back above the weekly open and continuation higher. And from the going back to the higher time frame perspective, still, in my opinion, basically, once we are going to clear that trend line again, which is corresponds with the weekly open right now, we might see higher levels towards 92.20.40 and 93.20.40. That's how I see Euro pound from the medium term perspective. We are going to have more updates from the intraday perspective here based on the calendar. We are trying to prepare ourselves for the whole week ahead of us. ZEV economic sentiment from the Germany, and then we do have US CPI. So in that case, Euro dollar is what we are going to go through right now. Overall, as you are going to see within the next few seconds, dollar is gonna be on the radar for the whole week. With Euro dollar, just short brief update. We test on Friday 50% of the old range. It's where we were looking for selling opportunity. So if you were able to trade shorts yesterday inside bar, trying to get out of that with the break to the downside, so the Friday low is the first target, the bottom of that old range. But I do think 115-114.50 medium term, from my perspective, I've been less active yesterday. From my perspective, I'm going to wait for this CPI today. I'm going to check if there is any kind of the upside reaction and if there is any chance for me to try to trade the short side. I'm not that active on the euro dollar because I'm long euro with pound, and at the same time I'm short dollar, I'm short pound with the dollar, but that's what we are going to discuss. So in that case, as long as we are below 1840, 1860, I think more downside to come, I'm going to make the US cash open update, so we are going to have the summary of the ZEF index of the CPI, and we are going to check where we are. For me, at that point, that's how I see the things going to play out. Now, Wednesday, it's gonna be also very, very interesting from the calendar perspective. We have European industrial production during the London session, all right? We have the German 30-year bond auction, and again, we have during the New York session, we have a focus. We are going to have a focus on the dollar. This time, we are going to have inflation from the producer's perspective. We do have PPI tomorrow, and we Wednesday and Thursday, there is going to be huge activity, monster activity when it comes to the Fed members. So again, dollar here is going to be the key. So let's check the another cross. This time, let's have a look what we have when it comes to the cable. In that case, again, we are testing strong supply between 3020, 3080. We hit 30, almost 3080 yesterday, and since then we are falling down. What is important? Well, we just tested weekly open, all right? And if you are a conservative, you wanna see the breakdown first, would be great to get the close below 30, and then you wanna sell the Rileys, and your first target is going to be around 20, 865, 2855. The next one is gonna be around 2770 and 2650, 2615 as the next one when it comes to the cable. And because dollar is on the radar, so next one is the dollar yen. Here we were bouncing based on the price action from the previous week. We are bouncing, and right now we are testing the supply. We are testing the previous week open, a little bit of the upper shadow with rejection when it comes to the indices. We are going to get back into that during the New York cash open, right? That might be interesting, but we also discussed possibility via pound yen, euro yen, or CAD yen, all right? What next when it comes to the calendar? On Thursday during the Tokyo session, Australian job market, as well as RBA Gov speaks. So in that case, very short update when it comes to the outcut. If you do remember, we discussed that if we are going to see during the Canadian data announcement move back towards the upper shadows we've seen last Wednesday and Thursday, that's a possibility to reshort, to add to the short, whatever. Boom! That's what happened here. I would be very careful because they're trying to hold the lower swing right now, right? So if you are trading from the Friday high or Monday high, okay, somewhere here, so maybe you wanna work with your exposure, work with stop or take partial profit. Be careful here, but it works as expected. I still do think that at some point this week we are going to see the breakdown and the lower level to come when it comes to outcad, right? Also, Thursday, again, dollar during the New York session, Philadelphia Fed manufacturing, unemployment claims, Empire State manufacturing index, import prices. Well, plenty of them. And as I mentioned before, Wednesday and Thursday, huge activity when it comes to the Fed members. Friday, we are not cooling off, still busy day. We are going to get retail sales out of the US, we are going to get industrial production capacity utilization rate, preliminary University of Michigan. So plenty of those things around. We discuss medium term when it comes to the majors. We are going to focus on intraday, going back to the US cash update, and that's my invitation for you. So see you around. Be careful. Have a great London session. Take care and goodbye.